Imperial officers could be seen wearing a number of different uniform colors, including green, black, white, or gray. Today I'll cover each uniform and what they all stood for within the ranks of the Galactic Empire. Most of this information will be canon, but I'll fill it in here and there with Legends material. Olive green is probably the most recognizable and common color seen in the films. Seen worn by Grand Moff Tarkin, Admiral Piette, Moff Gerard, and more, this color was reserved for Imperial Army and Naval officers. That's true in both canon and Legends. Black uniforms were worn by non-commissioned or low-ranking officers and stormtrooper officers. Star Wars Legends opened that up to prison guards and veteran TIE pilots as well, but I think prison guards would easily fall under the umbrella of non-coms. The white uniform was the most flexible of the bunch and was worn by officers who held a variety of positions. It could first be seen worn by Colonel Yularen aboard the Death Star, and it signified his standing in the Imperial Security Bureau. Director Krennic also had a white uniform, most likely to show his involvement in Imperial intelligence as part of the Tarkin Initiative. However, I could also see him just demanding to wear a white uniform to make himself stand out. His cape wasn't standard issue, but he had it at it anyway. It's along the same lines of his special Delta-class shuttle. He just wants to put on this appearance that he's more important than he is. But probably the most famous white uniform belonged to the Grand Admirals, like Thrawn or Rey Sloane. To make their tunics stand out even further, they were adorned with golden shoulder boards. Although they weren't Imperial officers, I did want to point out the gray uniforms worn by Imperial technicians. They were far more simple than the standard issue uniform, likely to match their lower status within the Empire. Stationed on capital ships or ground bases, they were in charge of maintenance and operations of various systems. Along those same lines, the scientists of the Tarkin Initiative had kind of an in-between variant of the uniform of officer and technician. Galen Erso could be seen wearing a multicolored green and gray uniform. And finally, the Imperial Press Corps had their own uniform and even insignias. They were worn by journalists that worked to spread Imperial propaganda on the HoloNet news. According to StarWars.com, they wore blue-gray uniforms, which is difficult to see through the holograms, but the character illustration of Alton Castle gives us a better look. There are, of course, more uniforms worn by the members of the Empire, but I wanted to focus on the officer uniforms, or at least uniforms that closely resembled them. Even then, there are still some outliers, like Ihsan Issard's red uniform from Star Wars Legends, but as far as I know, that was just a personal choice. Depending on how this video goes, I might cover the Imperial grunts in the future, but that's it for today. If you like this comprehensive style video, check out this playlist for more, and feel free to suggest more ideas like this in the comments. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and consider checking out our Patreon page. As always, thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.